Welcome, listeners. Thank you for taking the time out to listen to Wisdom Teachings. Without further delay, let's get right into the subject matter. SOD, Secrets of the Devil. Fact or fiction? You decide. The beginning. As the story goes, Lucifer was an angel of light, specifically a guardian cherub, who traded his cloak of righteousness for the cloak of evil darkness. And as the story goes, he was defeated in battle between himself and his father, who cast him down to the earth, known Lucifer, Satan, and other evil angels and demonic beings will only wreak havoc upon the earth. Then, a new character is introduced in the King James Bible story, namely Satan, who, according to Genesis 3 and 1, was designed on the fifth day of creation as a cunning, four-legged, wild animal to live in the Garden of Eden with Adam and Eve, who were created on the sixth day. You may be wondering why I'm rehearsing Lucifer and Satan's story. Well, it is to establish they are not the same person, and they were not designed the same way by Yahweh Jehovah, the Christian God. Satan's physical appearance. Now, the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made. Genesis 3 and 1. As Jesus explains in John 8 and 44 through 47, Satan was a murderer and the father of lies from the beginning of his existence because he was not created from the laws of light nor righteousness like Lucifer. From here, I will give you a scientific analysis of the difference between Lucifer and Satan's physical DNA composition, aka design, physical. The scripture says that the devil comes as an angel of light, 2 Corinthians 11:14. However, from a scientific perspective, that is not possible because there are no DNA molecules in his design to project light. You can understand this by examining human design. Satan and human beings were created from the same soil. Satan's spiritual nature. The laws Yahweh Jehovah designed in Satan's spiritual nature is from evil darkness, meaning all the laws of death, decay, and rot was written into his soul to govern himself by. This is why Jesus states there was never any light of righteousness in him, and that he was a murderer and the father of lies from the moment he caught his first breath. Genesis 3 and 1 and John 8 and 44. Moving on to Lucifer's physical appearance, Ezekiel 28, 12 through 15. King James Bible. Now, I'm not going to read that 3 pages of Lucifer's design. I want you to take the time. Actually, it's 2 pages of Lucifer's design. So I'm going to jump right into page 13, special notations. Number 1, Lucifer's material matter came from Yahweh, Jehovah's fire and light essence, because he was a cherub. It is then therefore conceivable that Lucifer can project light from his physical appearance. Again, Satan's physical body was made from the soil of the earth, and thereby, including his black soul, cannot project light physically. So when people say Satan revealed himself to them in an illuminated state, they truthfully met Lucifer or another fallen angel who has not lost all of his or her light energy molecules, because they were made from Yahweh's fire and light essence, and thereby is able to project life. Consider this perspective. There is never at any time darkness in the earth's sunlight. The light that proceeds from our sun never shifts to darkness. Only the intensity of the sun's light changes. However, that is due to cloud coverage and not the weakening of the sun's rays. Another special notation. The principles of science, logic, and reason pertaining to Lucifer's and Satan's design can be also applied to Yahweh, Jehovah. Now here, this is going to get interesting to you, and you might even find yourself a little offended. But this is what I understand. Based on the testimonies of Yahweh, and I'll explain. Yahweh, Jehovah, claims he is holy. However, that is not possible for the following reason. Yahweh operates in the laws of death and life. In fact, as Yahweh Jehovah has stated, he made man in his image and likeness. And as he also stated, because our design is a hybrid of good and evil, it nullifies human construction as holy, or composition as holy. Therefore, understand Adam's design. Adam was designed with two laws, the laws of death and life. This Paul confirms when he says there are two laws warring in his members, Romans 7:23. And if you're honest with yourself, you have knowledge of your own personal struggle. Should you go left or should you go right? Should you do good or should you do evil? Should you pick up peace or should you take up the mantle of revenge? So we're all struggling. We all have this composition. Now I'm going to move further on, but I hope you understand what I'm saying. As long as Adam's laws of death lie dormant within him, he was flawless and innocent. But the minute he transgressed Yahweh's commandment, Adam became a sinner because he is now operating in both laws. Do you get the connection? This is why it makes it impossible for Yahweh to be holy. And I'll explain further in the document. To simplify, a pine tree, for example, will never become or evolve into an orange blossom tree because it does not have the molecular DNA structure within it. A pine tree will remain a pine tree until it is mixed with another species of tree. At that point, you have a hybrid, and that pine tree is no longer a pine tree, but a mixture of opposite molecules having a unique identity. And so, based on the laws of science, logic and reason, and the testimony and wisdom of Yahweh, it is impossible for Yahweh himself to be holy because he too, like us human beings and the angels, operate in two laws. the laws of life and the laws of death. Understand, the laws of the Holy Spirit are life and purity. The Holy Spirit does not perform nor operate in good and evil, because the laws of evil is not a part of its composition, also known as design. Understand, the Holy Spirit knows and understands the moment it breaks one law of life or purity, it becomes polluted and no longer retains its purity and its existence as the God of life only. Again, the Holy Spirit operates only in the laws of life and purity. In summary, Yahweh Jehovah is a hybrid God whose composition is death and life. I know this is difficult for many of you to believe after you have heard all your life how holy, just, and righteous Yahweh is. But that is not the truth. Since the introduction of Yahweh Jehovah, the earth has grown, bled, and died. Death is Yahweh's composition too. This is why he is able to kill and destroy. Before he chose Satan to rule the earth, he ruled the earth with diseases, famines, wars, and death. As written in the book of Isaiah, Yahweh Jehovah confesses that he formed the light and created darkness. I made peace and I create evil. I, the Lord, do all these things. Isaiah 45:7. And in his image and likeness, so am I and every human being on this earth, including the angels in heaven and hell. Here is a mystery, and I'm about to change the subject slightly. Like Satan, who is operating with the permission and authority of Yahweh Jehovah in the earth, so are demons. I'm about to give you some demonology information. Understand, Satan's wisdom, knowledge, and power comes from Yahweh. And without Yahweh, he would be like a cabbage without a heart, meaning brain. All intelligence, knowledge, and supernatural power comes from Yahweh. So whatsoever a man or angel or beast or spirit possesses comes from Yahweh Jehovah. In the case of certain demons, they inherited their knowledge and power directly from their fallen angelic fathers and mothers, others from one another. In the underworld, this is called prostitution. Demons trade and exchange their knowledge and power between each other for survival. So where or what is witchcraft and sorcery? It is Yahweh's divine powers of creation and miracles used in reverse to do evil. So do y'all get that? The power of witchcraft and sorcery that demons operate in, including angels and men. That power is Yahweh's creation power, a miracle power used in reverse. So, although Yahweh's divine power is being used for evil, He is still the source of all powers, including Satan and Lucifer's. I have 4 points I want you to remember from this video. Number one, the Holy Spirit is the only being existing in perfect purity. Number two, all power or knowledge a man, angel, or demon possesses comes from Yahweh Jehovah, the Christian God, whether it is used for good or evil. Number three, Satan is from the brown soil of the earth. Number four, Lucifer is from Yahweh's divine fire and light essence. This is how come they cannot be the same person. Again, because Satan came from the soil of the earth, created on the fifth day of creation, and Lucifer was created thousands of years before him, and he was created as a cherub, and all the cherubs are born of Yahweh's fire and light essence. I hope you enjoyed this video. I do hope you will let me know. And I thank you for listening. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please do so now, that you may continue to receive notices of future videos. In the meantime, please tell me whether you like or dislike this video with comments and questions. Once again, thank you for listening to Lamppost Journal. Have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.